Today we're going to do the JCM800 mod. This is a VK100 head. I've got it propped up so the tubes don't touch. What we're going to do is we're going to solder in this area here and over here. What we're going to need for this is a soldering iron, some solder, some snips, some hookup wire, a DP-DT switch, a 430 k-ohm resistor, and some soldering paste. This resistor is to fix the switching delay, which is in one of my other videos, but we're going to do that while we're in there. So very quickly, for the channel switching delay fix, right behind the middle and base knobs you have R138 right here. This resistor is going to piggyback onto this lead and that lead. Now that we've got the resistor piggybacked, we're going to solder it on right there and right there. Now that it's been soldered, I'm going to snip off the leads. So now the channel switching mod is complete. We made short work of that. Let's start the JCM800. Prepare three pieces of jumper cables. Take the jackets off the ends. None of them are longer than 5 inches. So on the clean channel, middle and base knob, we're going to go up and over. Let's see if I can get it focused without shaking. Alright. So the area that you're going to be looking at is these two leads, the C106 and the R106. So these two, I'm going to see if I can hook this under here. Get it into the other one as well. Stuff to do while I'm holding the camera. But should be fairly simple. So I just looped the lead wire right under the two legs of this resistor. We're going to hit it with some solder and we're going to snip off this piece right here. Now that they're soldered together, I'll snip off the excess on the lead and we'll hook this end of the red lead to the switch. So if you can see R107, it's this resistor right here, and we're gonna snip this leg of R107. You want to snip it in a place where there's still metal sticking out from the board and you still have a little bit of lead on the left side of the resistor, because we need the resistor. So I've snipped it and I've bent the resistor up a little bit so we can work a little easier. And we're going to put a lead on that one and a lead on this end here. And both of the other ends of those leads are going to go to the switch as well. So now all our leads are soldered in place. Now we're going to hook them up to the switch. So all the leads are soldered on. I hope you can see where each lead goes on the switch. Next step is to drill a hole. I chose right here, and that's where the switch is going to come through.